Hello everyone, this is Shivangi ma'am here. I'm here to teach Standard 5 SST chapter number 2. And the previous chapter is already explained. Now I'll explain the chapter number 2, and the name of the chapter is Parallels and Meridians. Okay, so it is about previous chapter you read about Earth, and now you'll read about Earth's parallels and meridians. Okay, these are the imaginary lines which is drawn over the Earth. Okay, now let's get started. You have read that the Earth is spherical in shape. To find the location of places on the Earth, we need certain imaginary lines as reference. Okay, so you read about read that the shape of the Earth is spherical. Mostly means it is spherical in shape, like round in shape, and to read about its locations and to read about its places which is there on Earth, we need to put have a certain imaginary lines on it, and these lines are known as parallels and meridians. Okay, the Earth rotates on its axis. The Earth rotates means moves on its own axis, on its own place. It is an imaginary line drawn through the center of the Earth. So this is also an imaginary line which is drawn through the center of the Earth. Understand? The end points on the axis are called poles. So these axis, on its own axis it moves, and the pole, the end points of this axis is called poles. The end points of this axis is known as poles, and we have two poles, which is North Pole and South Pole. The point on the top is known as North Pole, and the point on the bottom is known as South Pole. So you understand, there are two poles, which is North Pole and South Pole. So why we need parallels and meridians? We need these imaginary lines to know the location of the places which is there on the Earth. Okay, now first we'll read about parallels. A set of circles is drawn on the surface of the globe. These circles run from east to west. They are called parallels or lines of latitude. Okay, so these imaginary lines which is drawn from east to west, the imaginary line which is drawn from east to west are known as parallels of the Earth, or it is also called latitude. Okay. The Earth is divided into two equal parts by drawing an imaginary line. So this, the Earth is divided into, you can see here, in 2.1 parallel and lines of latitudes are made. These are the imaginary lines. In real it is not there. In reality it's not there. Okay. So one imaginary line is also there which divides Earth in two parts. Okay. This line is called the equator. So that line which divides Earth into two equal parts, that is known as equator. Okay, now it is the longest parallel, and equator is known as the longest parallel imaginary line. Understand? Equator divides the Earth into two equal parts. The part of the Earth which lies the north of the equator is called the northern hemisphere. So that part which lies in the northern part from the equator is called northern hemisphere, and that which is below the equator, which is the other half which is near the south, that is known as southern hemisphere. Okay, lies to the south of the equator. So southern hemisphere lies to the south of the equator, and northern hemisphere lies to the north of the equator. Important features of parallels. Now, what are the important features? What are the things that parallel lines helps us? Okay, so all parallels are complete circles except for the North Pole and the South Pole. These are points. So every parallel line is a complete circle. Every parallel imaginary line is a complete circle, and except the South Pole and the North Pole. That South Pole and the North Pole are known as points, not the circle. So every parallel ring is a circle, complete circle. The length of the parallels decreases as we move away from the equator. So as we move away from the equator means towards the North Pole and towards the South Pole, the measurement, the length of the that circle decreases, okay? Because it is a sphere. All parallels are located at an equal distance from each other, and whatever these imaginary lines are at equal distance from each other, they have equal distance. In dono ke jo jagah hoti hai beech mein, that is equal. Okay, parallels neither touch nor cross one another. So these parallels never touch each other or never cross over each other. Okay, so you read about the important features of parallels. Every parallel is a complete circle, and when we move towards the pole, the length of the circle decreases, and also all the parallels are at equal distance from each other and they do not cross over each other. Okay, now how are parallels numbered? We start from the equator and mark it as 0 degree latitude. So of course every these parallels starts from the equator. So we start doing the measurement from the equator itself, and and there the parallel is known as 0 degree latitude. Okay, we mark the another parallels from 0 degree to 90 degree. Now the another parallel we measure that is 0 degree to 90 degree. Okay, apart from their value, the parallels are also marked N north, S south according to their location. So apart from these degrees, it also this the upper means the lines which is above the equator, that is marked as north, and which is below the equator, that is marked as S. Okay, the North Pole is written as 90 degree north. So it is with those parallels which lies in the northern hemisphere, that is known as 90 degree north. The South Pole is written as 90 degree south. Okay, parallels are drawn at intervals of 1 degree. So every parallel is drawn at interval of 1 degree. There are 90 parallels in the northern hemisphere and 90 parallels in the southern hemisphere. So there are in the northern hemisphere means above the equator, there are 90 parallels means 90 circles, imaginary lines, and below equator also there are 90 parallels. So together they are, so therefore they are, there are 181 parallels in all including the equator. Okay, so there, how many parallels are there? There are 181 parallels in total and including equator line also. Okay, so you understand how are parallels numbered. Now important parallels. Other than the equator, which is 0 degree, the North Pole, which is 90 degree north, and the South Pole, which is 90 degree south, there are 4 other important parallels also. So apart from these parallels, there are 4 more important parallels. First one is Tropic of Cancer, which is at degree 23.5 degree north, the upper one. This lies in the upper one. The Tropic of Capricorn, which is below the equator and known as 23.5 degree south. The measurement is 23.5 degree south. The Arctic Circle, which is in the north, with the measurement is 66.5 degree north. Okay, and the last one is the Antarctic Circle, which is in the south, 66.5 degree south. Understand? So apart from these equator and all the parallel lines, there are 4 important parallel lines, which is the Tropic of Cancer, the Tropic of Capricorn, the Arctic Circle, and the Antarctic Circle. Understand? The Arctic and the Antarctic circles are called polar circles. These two circles are very, they have a very cold season throughout the year. And these are known as the polar circles, means the cold place. Understand? Now you read about the parallels, now you'll read about meridians. So parallels are the imaginary lines, and meridians are also imaginary lines. Imaginary lines running from north to south. So parallels were the imaginary lines which runs from east to west, from east to west, and also known as latitude, and these meridians runs from north to south and also known as longitude. Okay, these all are imaginary lines. In reality, it's not there. So we need these imaginary lines to know the location of the earth, location of the places which is on the earth. Okay, so these lines are drawn from pole to pole, from north pole to south pole. These lines are drawn. Now, what are the important features of meridians? We'll read about that. All meridians are of the same length. So, all the meridians means all the imaginary circles are of same length. Okay? The maximum distance between any two meridians is at the equator. So, the maximum distance which is the maximum distance between two meridians. Two meridian means imaginary lines. It is that maximum distance lies at the equator itself. Okay? So, at the poles, it has very, very less distance. Okay? The meridians cut the parallels at right angles. So, these parallel which runs from east to west, these and the meridians which runs from north to south, these cut the parallel lines at 90 degree. Okay? 90 degree is right angle. Okay? Meridian are used to measure distances in the east-west direction. So, meridians are used to find the direction, measure the distances in the east-west direction. Okay? So, these both lines are helps us to find the location. Now, how are meridians numbered? Now, we'll read how these meridians, imaginary lines, are numbered on the earth. You have read that the number of parallels we start from the equator. Similarly, we need a starting point to the number of meridians. Like as parallel lines are numbered from the equator, so this meridians are also need to be numbered. It should have any starting point. So in 1884, it was decided to fix Greenwich, a place near London, as the starting point for numbering meridians. So this was held in 1884, a place which is in London, which is near the London, and the name of the place is Greenwich. It was decided that we will measure the poles from that very point. The meridian that passed through Greenwich was marked 0 degree and named prime meridian. So that point Greenwich is known as the starting point to measure the poles, and this Greenwich lies near the London, and that point was marked as 0 degree. Okay, and that is named as prime meridian. So prime meridian is the point from which the meridian it is a starting point of the meridians. Understand? The longitude of a place is measured east or west of the prime meridian. So from prime meridian, it is measured from east to west. Understand? Like parallels, meridians are also drawn at intervals at 1 degree. So it's similar from parallels also. These meridians are also at distance of 1 degree. If we move away from the prime meridian towards the east or the west, we reach halfway round the earth at 180 degree. So if we start from the prime meridian, like it is saying, if we move away from the prime meridian, if we will move away from the prime meridian, the starting point of the longitude, towards the east or west, we reach halfway round the earth at 180 degrees. From there we will reach the halfway earth, and which is 180 degrees. Thus there are 180 meridians towards the east of the prime meridian and 180 meridians towards the west. So in total there are 180 meridians, 180 imaginary lines towards the east and the west also. So altogether it became 360 meridians. Okay, like as parallel was measured above and below, north and south, this meridians are measured from as towards east and towards west. Understand? Now locating places on the globe. So these are the imaginary lines you read about. Now we'll read how it helps in locating the places on the earth. The parallels and the meridians form a network of lines on the Google. So on the globe, sorry, I'm sorry. So these are the imaginary lines which builds up the network of lines on the globe. This is called a grid. So these networks, these parallels and the meridians together are known as the grid. G-R-I-D, grid. And what is grid? Grid is a network of the parallels and meridians. Network lines of the parallels and meridians. We used to locate places on the, this grid is used to locate the places on the globe. Okay, it divides the earth, and through that we can locate the place. To locate a place, we must know the values of its parallel and latitude and its meridian or longitude. So before knowing, we should know the measurement of parallel and meridians. Okay, the point at which the parallel and the meridian cross each other is the location of that place. So at that very point where the meridian and the parallel cross each other, that is known as the location of that very place. Understand? So this parallels and meridians helps us to locate places on the earth. These are totally imaginary lines we build up to measure the places and to find the locations on the earth. Understand? So here your chapter is completed. I'll provide you the word meaning and the question answer work through WhatsApp group. Stay home, stay safe.